Hi friends, are you frustrated with the chrome stamp or the healing brush on your 360 photo seam line when you do raw HDR color correction? What if this is a 360 video and your beloved denoising or coloring tool create that ugly seam line every time you use them? What if you want to use some of your favorite 2D drawing effects, the Red Giant Universe or BorisFX Continuum or Sapphire? Again, the ugly seam line. And today, I'm going to show you how to easily get rid of that ugly seam line without complicated rotoscoping or rely on a chrome stamp brush. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. Before we dive right in how to get rid of the seam line, let's take a deeper look at what is the problem, why we need this kind of solution. So if you remember from my last tutorial, how to color grade GoPro Fusion with the GoPro flat Pontoon color profile, I used one of my favorite coloring plugins by Red Giant called Colorista. And as you see that one of the magical features I use in Colorista, let me just turn it on right here. This footage is shot with the GoPro Fusion, but again, any 360 video camera, including the GoPro Fusion, the E, the Insta360 One, the Insta360 Pro, any 360 camera you use, that is a common issue because any 360 camera you shot give you an eco rectangular footage like this one right here. Very, very dark from the subject, which is a DJ, my friend Saucy right here. She's really dark. If you remember that tutorial, one thing I do, let me just zoom right in right here. Go to Saucy. One thing I do here is I go into Colorista and then I go into their structure and lighting. And from here, I bring down the highlight a lot so the background is not blowing out. And then I bring up the shadow a lot. So as you see her face start coming out. But again, that also brings up the noise, right? And then one thing I do, because the footage is really soft, I'm using something called pop right here. And I just be a little bit dramatic right here. And then as you see, when I finish the effect, I create this really, really ugly seam line right here. So if you actually not go so extreme as I do here, that seam line sometimes is not noticeable, so it's alright, depend on how you position your camera. But in this scenario, I actually position my camera, the back of the camera is facing the DJ, the seam line is right across her face, so this will look really ugly. And this problem even more dramatic if you put in denoiser right here. One of my favorite denoiser plugin is actually by right here, Neat Video. It's a very, very famous and really, really strong denoising plugin. Not every traditional 2D videographer use that on any DSLR footage. It's a great plugin. It actually works great for GoPro Fusion or any other 360 video camera as well. But that is also the common problem. When you use that, sometimes if you use it too much, you also see the really strong seam line right here. And that's actually a very, very common workflow if you denoise and color grade your footage in After Effects or Premiere with some of the HDR effects. So that's why we need a solution to get rid of the seam line. Then you can use your traditional color grading technique to really apply in monoscopic or even stereoscopic 360 video. And in this tutorial, I'll show you exactly how to get rid of that. And on bonus, I'm also gonna show you any special effect you used to use in a 2D. And you can actually apply it as well in 360 as well. The common issue again for those effects is it also creates a seam line because any 2D effect is not edge aware. If not edge aware, the effect doesn't know that this is the left, it's the right, and it's actually connect together. And that's the reason why create a seam line. The only effect that doesn't have the seam line is by the original Adobe Immersive Effect Tool, the Metal Skyboard, if a little bit old school, know where's that come from. But besides that, all the effects you put into a 360 video will create the seam line like you see right here. So this one is with the very famous Red Giant Hollow Matrix. It's a really great effect and turn any footage into a sci-fi looking film. As you see, this ugly seam line right here cut right through the actor's face right here. Because that is a 2D effect, it doesn't know that it's a 360 video. So the technique to actually get rid of the seam line is rely on a third-party plugin called anyFX360 right here. You can get this plugin easily on AEScript. So go ahead and download the plugin and install into your After Effects. After that, on your window, you will see the anyFX360 plugin. So just check that. And then we should open this little panel right here. And then you can dock it into a side panel. Before we get started, first go ahead and pre-comp this. And then on your anyFX360 panel, go ahead and hit new effects. And now we generate an adjustment layer. So right here, you can drop in the same color correction effect you used on the regular video. And in here, as you see the colorista, we also have the HDR effect right here. Now, to see the final rendering by anyFX360, go ahead and hit output. And as you see, the ugly seam line is non-existent anymore. Right here, you will not see the seam anymore. If you cannot see really clearly, go ahead and the GoPro VR player. So as you see now, you will not able to see the stitch line or the seam line anywhere in the video. As you see the pan around, it's seamless. Great. So now let me show you how to add special effect, like the traditional 2D effects coming from your traditional 2D filter into the anyFX360 layer to overlay multiple effects to create a special seamless look. So go ahead and find the red giant universe stylized and go ahead and drop in the hollow matrix onto the same layer on top of our color correction layer. And then go ahead and just, again, hit the output. Let anyFX360 do its magic. So now if you pan around, again, you will not see the stitch line right here. And it's seamless. But let's try a more realistic effect. This effect is way too much. So go ahead and hit the edit effects right here. Go back into anyFX360 layer. Go ahead and remove the hollow matrix. And we go down to find BorisFX Continuum. BTC11 blur. And we go ahead and add the spiral blur on top of the layer, on top of colorista. And then go ahead and change the setting. And pick from blur to smear. And then again, go ahead and hit output. And as you see, this effect is also seamless. Probably better to look at in the GoPro VR player. Pan around. The blur effect is seamless. If you go up and down look at the effect kind of converge into the top point in this like ugly point right here. In the bottom, I kind of like destroy the top and bottom. So we can also fix that with anyFX360. Let me show you how. So go ahead and hit the edit effects again. Go back into the edit comp. And then right here in the setting, we can blend in the pole right here. Turn on pole blend. And let's blend in maybe like 50 pixel. And if you pay attention to the border right here, that is show you how much blend you should have with the effects with the original layer. So it might be a little bit too much. Let's do it 40. And then go ahead and hit output. Now go ahead and pan in the top and bottom. Let me actually show you in the GoPro VR player, if it's on top and bottom, now the effect looks more natural because the zoom in effect is supposed not be in the bottom with the tripod area on the top. So now it blends the effect with the original layer. So you don't need to worry about the ugly conversion point on the top and the bottom. And the effect look more smooth now. Finally, I want to show you, you can actually use After Effects as a color grading tool for 360 photo as well. So you don't need to go through that complicated Photoshop effect to like get rid of the scene with the chrome stamp too. So let me show you how. Go ahead and find a 360 image. So I actually have an image right here captured with the Mavic Pro with the panorama image feature. So drop it into the sequence in After Effects and it's a PNG. So go ahead and create a new comp with the PNG file. So you can see this PNG file. Right now it's to create a seamless 360 image. But now I want to color correct and color grade this image. So you can just color grade the picture just how you color grade video file. So again, I will use Colorista right here, but again, you can use any color grading software you used to. I mean, if you know how to color grade, the principle is the same, just as in the camera raw or in the Lightroom. So go ahead and drop in Colorista. So again, after I do the grading, as you see right here, if you pay attention, pan around here, you see the ugly seam line right here. And it happened the same if you use it in Lightroom or Adobe Camera Raw. So again, right, copy the stem effects, just select the layer, again, open anyFX 360, right here, hit new effects on this comm layer, and then this time drop in the color correction effect on the adjustment layer and go ahead and hit output. But look at, we have different comm here, so actually output is on this one. And if you pan around, now the HDR image is seamless. I will actually go ahead and go back in here, hit setting to blend in the pole a little bit, hit output. So now the pole blend in a little bit better. Especially the drone shot, people actually do look down below right here. And then since this is just a PNG, you can just go back to the first frame right here, render and save frame as Photoshop layer. Actually save frame as files, as a Photoshop file. Go ahead, hit render. If you open Photoshop now, and then drop in that layer right here. If you open filter, actually 3D under vehicle panorama, new panorama from layer. It's a really big file, by the way. If you turn around right now, you will not be able to see the seam line neither. So it's perfectly correct. Thank you for watching. If you want to learn more about 360 video or 360 photo post-production, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell for upcoming release. If you like this video, don't forget to give me a thumb up, and I will see you next time.